it has been done. Oh man, Magic the Gathering.
I really wish they'd bring back the color theming on, like, you remember, like, in the early iterations of this client, they had, like, different color themes you could choose.
Did they just get rid of that completely?
They did just get rid of it completely. It's like they went into, like, some sort of, like, forced day where you had to use this instead of V3.
Yeah, oh, yeah, okay, I remember
and
that.
And when they like, released that client, they got rid of the customization options, which is too bad, because I always use the blue-green, like, Simic version. And they're like, we're going to use one that forces it to look great by our standards. I was like, that's... All right, I guess.
Man, looking at this, they certainly want you to play leagues, don't they?
Yeah, how many, well, there's a good number of Kaladesh drafts far enough right now.
Yeah, there definitely are. It's just, I'm like, the number of queues.
Right, oh yeah, they're like, yeah.
Versus over here, where it's just like, yo, jump on in.
Yeah, and they've got, 22,000 people currently in the Kaladesh League.
Mm-hmm. I'm still hanging out here for now.
Look, it's cheaper now. It only costs 120 tickets, not 140.
Yep.
Play points. 12 tickets versus 14. Mm-hmm. Basically, the price of entry is now just the product instead of the product plus two tickets.
I always wondered what the heck the two tickets, like, it's just like we're skimming two off the top for...
Yeah, it's weird. I don't know why. It's really dumb. I'm really glad that they didn't. Yeah. They don't do that anymore now. Now it just costs the product to enter, which is right. Good. That's how it always should have been. But.
Well, right, because, like, this isn't like a shop, you know?
Right.
Like,
well, like, honestly, well, let's talk about the draft.
Well, yeah, let's go ahead and see what we got here in our opener. No masterpieces. Key to the City.
Hmm, it's a good card.
Yeah, make creature unblockable and also, like, cycling cards, Mountain Below the
Cup. Yeah. It's like pay two to tool almost. The creature becomes unblockable. But we got others. Malphus Doorbuster is pretty good.
Yeah, I'm looking at like about five or six in here. We've got the power of like a pretty powerful pacifism. We got the power of like one of the best vehicles for aggressive decks.
Yep.
We got the power of Unlicensed Disintegration, which is a bit much for a first pick, yeah. But this is a very powerful
card. Yeah, it is. It's just that it puts into two colors. The nice thing about the Freighter is it doesn't put you into any colors, same with Key to the City. Rogue Privileges puts you into white, but, you know, that's a pretty good card to start with.
Yeah, right, just good pacifism.
Mm-hmm. You know, if you cut that here, the only white here is Trusty Companion, which is... good, but not like a nuts card.
I'm between these two. I'm between the Revoke Privileges and the Renegade, and I think the Doorbuster. This card should be good. I just don't know. Like, okay. Let's take a look at what we got in here. Paradoxical Outcome is our rare.
Well, if we'd taken the vehicle, then Spire Set Infiltrator would have been a pretty easy pick.
Yeah.
But we didn't. Is that still... it's not looking great. Like, the only other good white card here is Sky Swirl Harrier, but it's also, like, a 5-drop, so...
Yeah, it's not too great. I'm a fan of...
This is kind of a weak pack, honestly.
It could be, like, Sky Skiff or even Thriving Rhino. I like the green in this pack a lot.
Yeah, Hunt the Weak and Thriving Rhino, that's not a bad... Those aren't too bad things to look at.
Yeah.
I mean, it's fine. I think if you're gonna go into another color here, like... It's red or green, and red would be the Infiltrator, but Thriving Rhino can just go into more stuff.
Right, well, the thing is, like, this thing attacks very heftily.
Oh, yeah. It attacks as a 3-4.
This thing's also really good. I have a lot of trouble, so I've still not gotten to play with vehicles. I've had to play against them a lot, but I've not gotten to play with a vehicle, so it's very hard for me to,
like... Okay.
Okay, Shrunder's Pyro Helix. Propeller Pioneer, though, is the card I'm...
No green, but then there's only two cards missing, so, like...
One uncommon, one common, or foil.
Or foil, yeah.
But yeah, no, this thing does a lot of work as far as, like, just attacking in. I am very impressed by this creature every time I saw it.
Pioneer's great.
Yeah, Madcap Experiment is not a card you play in Limited.
Man, it's a cool card, though.
It is.
I like Madcap Experiment.
There's no way you're casting that Limited, though. Like, you just, you're gonna lose the game for that. This card is very powerful, though. There are a lot of times... I played two of them in my sealed deck over the weekend, and I think it was 50-50 on me either making it, like, fabricated or unfabricated. Just based off of, like, sometimes I needed a blocker for a different flyer plus a blocker on the ground, or...
Or, like, for me, when I played with it, sometimes it's like, oh, okay, well, hello there, Captured... Hello there, Rogue Privileges times two. Wow. Red's also very open, Red's and there's no green in here either, so it looks like that Rhino may not end up in the deck.
Right.
But, yeah. I've had things like, I've had, Chief of the Foundry? And then it's just like, oh, I'll Pioneer, because then next turn when I Chief of the Foundry, I'll get a 2-2 instead of, like, that. But, yeah, Captured by the Consulate.
Yeah, this is, it's four, it's a little expensive for a Pacifism, and it only does the can't attack, but it basically says your opponent also can't play removal.
Uh-huh. I actually saw somebody played Chandra's Pyro Helix to get around that.
Yeah, because you can one in one on your opponent's two targets.
Yeah, one their face. Yeah, or like one their face, one a creature, and then But no, Capture the Consulate. Like, if it's a big creature, they still can't attack. They can still like block with it, but what's?
I'm almost intrigued to pick up the Thriving Grubs here because the red looked very open. Blue is also pretty good in this pack. Malfunction and Aether Tradewinds are pretty powerful stuff.
Malfunction will be our third enchantment removal spell in five picks. But I'm okay with taking up removal really early, because that means you don't need to make those hard choices later in the draft where, like, man, this is a really good creature, but man, I need any amount of removal right now.
Yeah.
I liked how open red was.
That's kind of what I'm going for here. Is I'm hoping that the red continues to be open, because we saw two Pyro Helixes and a Welding Sparks. I would bet that there's probably a player on our left that's going to go into it, but also we might just keep seeing the red coming, and maybe we do, maybe we don't. But I'll take the bet. Okay.
Yeah. Sure. What? Well, I think we know that like one of our colors is correct.
Yeah, white is still here. White has the problem of a couple cards I just, like, I don't like Inspired Charge, but, like...
It's okay in a very unique deck, but then that deck also just wants the green-white pump spell instead, so...
I'm also laughing, like, also, we would have a problem if our opponent played Captured by the Consulate, because then all of a sudden we would have to arrest, like, our own creep.
You have to keep arresting the person that's already been captured by the consulate.
Look, we're double arresting you.
Please don't.
You're under arrest again. Black
is here. Look at
I can also pick up, like, there's okay green in the High Spire Artisan.
Yeah, then you only have Thriving Rhino.
Right.
And, like, the Weaponcraft Enthusiast is, you know, pretty good guy. Malfa Squad is pretty powerful. Like, I'm okay with any of the black cards here, honestly.
Yeah. We're leaving ourselves, like, very open. I guess, yeah, there's also just Elephant, if I want to...
I think I'd rather, like, go towards, make it so that we can move into a third color here, basically, you know?
Second color, even, at this point, like... We're just
so we have a third color that we can move into as our second color, is what I mean.
Right. Wow.
I'm a pretty big fan of the Pillar Bug.
Yeah, I was going to say Pillar Bug or Cobra are the two I'm looking at.
It depends on what you think you have more of a chance of getting into. We're not getting anything else green in this on the wheel.
Right.
That's for sure.
Serpent's probably the most powerful card in the pack in the abstract.
It is.
Fireweaver, Foundry Screecher.
And, the Screecher's pretty good.
The Trusty Companion came back around?
Yeah, okay, sure. I mean, the Screecher is pretty powerful if we have a lot of Fabricate. Also, Subtle Strike is actually pretty good.
Yeah.
Like, the fact that it gives puts a +1/+1 counter on instead of just, like, +1/+1 till end of turn. Is that you can, get rid of a servo and make your guy bigger. But, I like sticking with the companion, I think, just so that we stay in white more.
I think this co also that tells me that our color is certainly correct.
All right. Well.
I'm just gonna pick up like the a person. This is just a body. Also just a body. Sure.
Okay. Yeah, looks like.
Okay, let me.
Looks like black is somewhat open.
Yeah, at the moment it looks like black is color two. Let me actually resort this correctly and give it a little more size. Okay. White is at 100% though. That looked really like all five of our white cards were powerful and also in like,
I'm hoping that we'll get the there are some good cards I want to pick up, but it means that generally what this deck's gonna want to do is we're gonna want to get a lot more fabricate. We're gonna want to get a lot of the black cards that care about you controlling an artifact, and we're almost always going to be making servers instead of +1/+1 counters, like Restoration Gearsmith or like Gear Hulk. And I will say, if that Gear Hulk were not here, then Restoration Gearsmith is the card you want for the deck. But the Gear Hulk's here.
So the Gear Hulk's
So
here.
maybe we're playing green, who knows?
The worst part is there's also a Skywailer shot that's my favorite white kill spell in the world. It kills everything.
It's how is that like better than Hunt the Monstrous? That's that the card I'm
Smite.
thinking of?
Smite.
Smite the Monstrous. How is that better than Smite the Monstrous in every single respect?
It's so ridiculous.
It costs one less mana, it can target more things, and you get to scry off it.
I'm gonna put this in the pile now. We
Do that.
I guess we'll have to see what we can pick up that makes green look better. Oh my god. Hey.
Nice. Nice. That seems pretty good with the Gear Hulk, I gotta say.
Yep, I think that's a good curve.
Turn 4, Gear Hulk, all the plus one, or distribute all the plus one plus one counters. Attack with it. Next turn.
Do it
Okay, I
again.
angel it. Now I put all the counters on itself.
I put him. I'm good. If we weren't in this deck, the Imbrawl Bruiser would be a little bit more the pick. Prophetic Prism would be a realistic choice as well.
By the way, you just paid for a draft for that,
I know.
so.
I know. Viridius. That was like Viridius Gear Hulk is the most expensive mythic that isn't named Chandra in the set, to my knowledge. Actually, Nissa might be a little more expensive too. I don't know what
Can take
Nissa's
that.
in.
What's this Nessa called? Oh, Nature's Artisan. Or no, that's not the one. That's the fake
Yeah.
baby one.
All
There it
right,
is. Vital
but
Force.
yeah.
Yeah, Vital. She's worthless. Okay, Glint's of Artisan. That is a great card.
That's perfect for us. This is the three drop creature we want because it's both the like it's both a 3/3 for three or a 2/2 and a 1/1 and works well with Works it works well enough with Wispweaver Angel if like we Wispweaver can do just like untapping a creature after attacking or like getting a free servo, that sort of thing. A Cogworker's Puzzle Knot would be acceptable too, though I'd probably pick the Sky Swirl.
Look at all this, like, even though we picked the Gear Hulk, we may still not want to be in green.
I know, like, there's nothing here.
Yeah, like, it sucks, but like, yeah. Ornamental Courage.
We'll look at our look at the white in this pack though too.
Yeah, this hack's just kind of
I
bad.
was gonna
The
say,
Subtle Strike.
I was gonna say, is Subtle Strike just the best thing in this pack?
I
Like,
think it is.
well, I mean,
Yeah.
I guess that actually the red in here is the best color in the abstract, but we're
It
not in red.
is. Yeah, we're definitely not there because either we're playing black because we actually have like good cards already in that color, or we're playing green because we have a Gear Hulk.
Creature, cat, monkey. When it's cranked. But yeah, Inspire
Monkey's a
Charge
creature
and
type
Pressure
now.
Point are no dice. Ornamental Courage is the worst of the two combat tricks in green because the other one outclasses it by about 1,000%. The +2/+2 and Hexproof.
Yep, that one's is it uncommon, but yes.
Well, yeah, I guess I mean on the one mana trick thing.
Yes, exactly. But yeah, Subtle Strike is actually quite a good card. Ooh, Fretwork Colony, Foundry Screecher, Accomplished Automaton.
Mantha Rich Control is whenever a creature leaves play, all right?
Whenever you control leaves play, yeah, yes. So if it gets bounced or, you know, flickered or killed or anything. So it's kind of a upgraded Unruly Mob.
Yeah, basically, it's just Unruly Mob, but better in any conceivable way outside of not being a human.
Also, Fretwork Colony, which can get pretty big pretty quick, but it's pretty soft to, pacifisms.
I would say pacifism really shows it up, and that's no good.
Then again, we have all the pacifisms, so who cares?
That's fine, then. Let's try out the card. Hey, Wispweaver number 2.
Ooh.
Wild.
We burn that midnight oil. So Wild Wander is an interesting choice, because it means that we could try to do 3 color, but then it looks like green would be our splash. I honestly think that we have enough good stuff with, like, good ETBs that we could just play multiple Wispweaver Angels.
Yeah, that's kind of the thing. Like, basically, it's do I plan on playing this Viridius Gearhulk?
And I don't think you plan on it at this point.
I'd like to, but I also agree with you.
I would love to as well, but, like, there's no green support here. We would destroy ourselves trying to play that card.
Yeah, and then we would win, like, the games we cast it and lose every game we don't get to... I should have picked the D-Tutor.
Oh, you know what? You need to pick up that guy that leaves the battlefield. Is it going to get both Wispweaver Angels? The other option is if you can pick up a Panharmonicon.
Oh,
that
yeah.
rare card that doubles things. Sky Sift's good. Whirler Maker's also, like...
That's one of the few mana sinks in the format. Mm-hmm. Sky Sift, I'm thinking about because we have Weaponcraft Enthusiast,
yeah.
Guildsleeve
yeah,
Artisan,
sure.
Malphus Squad, Propeller Pioneer, and so we have all these one...
Lots of things that give us, yeah, one power things.
Yeah. Whirler Maker's also quite powerful, don't get me wrong, but I think this makes use of our 1-1s a little bit more.
Yep.
Also, Thriving Grasp, get out of here, you're not in the deck.
Yeah, that can definitely get out. That can definitely get out. Let's just leave the Gearhulk in for
I was
now.
I'll say, I'm not...
Just so we can admire it, you know?
Yeah. Sky Skiff.
Glintsleeve, hello.
That's
if we were more in a vehicle, that Night Market would be pretty sick.
Right, like, Night Market into Sky Skiff is a powerful combo. Like,
yeah.
That pilot combination is very good. Mm-hmm. But Glintsleeve with the Sky Skiff is great.
Honestly, Nightmarker on turn 1, like, just being able to attack that next turn and almost always get in for a free damage, like, free 2 damage. And then, you know, but then after you need vehicles, otherwise it just turns into a 1-1 that doesn't do anything.
Yep. Okay. So this is our pack back. Looks like we've got Acrobatic Maneuver, Mind Rot, Accomplished Automaton.
I'd be going with a Maneuver here. Because it seems like we're gonna be pretty often wanting to make the servo instead of making the instead of putting on plus one counter.
Mm-hmm.
Which means we can kind of like flat like we could like flicker a you know like say Weaponcraft Enthusiast and get 2 creatures for free.
I'm fine with that especially over what we have. We don't need more top end.
Like Mind Rot. I kind of like the Accomplished Automaton as top end.
I don't think we need more of it, but I also think it's the best card here.
Yeah, because the other one is another Precata Club Security, which, like, no thank you.
Yeah, we already have one of those anyway. I'm going
to... Okay, well, Winsmith is actually a decent card. The other ones is counter groups, so, yeah.
Wow, Select for Inspection still hanging out here, too.
Yeah, it is.
This card is really bad, except for in the deck where it is functional.
It destroys us?
In which case, you lose the game. Like,
yeah.
Let's Subtle Strike to into the wrong pile.
Oh. Okay, so... This... I think we could use a few more, like, 1 or 2 more nuts, uncommons, or rares. That'd be great. Oh.
Okay, so this time around, this pick, we have... Animation Module, which is really good with all the Fabricate we have hanging out.
It's very good, I think.
Yeah, like, the card is kind of hard, so this is hard to pin down. Whenever a +1/+1 counter is placed on a permanent you control, you may pay 1 to make a servo, and then 3, put a counter on a thing, which can be, but the thing is, we have Glintsleeve Artisan, Glintsleeve Artisan, Fretwork Colony, Weaponcraft Enthusiast, Malphus Squad, Propeller Pioneer, Wispweaver Angels on anything, and if somehow we cast Viridius Gearhulk,
somehow. if there are like any, I guess at this point we can just like highly pick prophetic prisms.
Yeah. Also, this fact is really good too, just because like even outside of that we have Glintsleeve Artisan, and like I'd want one fragmentized main is about what I'd play.
Mm-hmm. I have some words to note. I just realized that the Gearsmith didn't come back. The black white person.
That's correct. That means somebody else is in our colors flat. Yep. Or is splashing for that card, because that's a very easy splash.
That's entirely possible. If they're playing green, and then they're just like, you know, green, black, or green, white. Hey, how about that guy?
Whenever your opponent casts a non-creature spell, drain two. What's it competing against?
That guy's pretty good. Bizarre Barge just gets you a card when it enters the battlefield. Server Exhibition is just sorcery speed, raise the alarm, but, you know, a bit more synergy. Eddie Trail Hawk's actually pretty powerful.
Yes.
Flying
is king in this format.
Mm-hmm. And besides that, not much in our colors. So, it's absolutely the best card here.
Yeah. Bizarre Barge is the worst vehicle.
It says draw a card on it.
Right. It just says draw a card on it, though.
We could, like, crew it and then acrobatic maneuver it.
Metallurgic Summons. Built to Last, looking good.
Mm-hmm. There's a second trusty companion, but I think the Built to Last is just something we want.
That's a good trick.
Mm-hmm. Plus, like, you know, if you cast on, like, a Pillar Bug or something like that.
Yeah.
Or Servo, it doesn't go away.
I would say Servo's probably the one where that's happening the most, but Pillar Bug, that's 4 points of lifelink.
Yeah, right. You're basically black, white, and 10 plus 2 plus 2 indestructible and lifelink. Which means you're gaining back a pretty amount of life and generally killing whatever they have and making it so your dude's not susceptible to a combat trick back.
Can we ask, what format is flying not king? I guess let me step back
Tempest.
And. Shadow. Walk through what I was saying a little more. Flying in this set's a little rarer. And that means flying itself is more valuable because there are less flyers to get in the way. Like, I have seen Wind Drake just end games because a 2-2 flyer could not be answered. Ooh, we could Rush of Vitality. We could.
I like that.
We could. Yeah, Rush of Vitality here.
You get our second Trusty Companion, Wheel of Third Ones that we're always playing Trusty Companions on turns 2 and 3, and then, like, they can be companions to each other. It's fine. They'll act together.
The ground the ground tends to be gummed up with servos, too. That's entirely true.
I like the Rush of Vitality. I'm also looking at the Cogworker's Puzzle Knot, but I think the Vitality is just a better pick here.
Yeah. Burnhead, that's a good point. In dragons, everyone has dragons, so flying is less valuable in the world. Like,
that's true.
So they're like flying always is a good value, but in some worlds, Windrake is more powerful than in others.
Mm-hmm. How's off to read a flying right now? You have one flyer.
We got Wisps. We were angels. That's it.
Oh, never mind. We're good. Hey, that's a guy.
Ripley's here.
And look, yes. You know what we have if we went into green. Well, we still have Visionary Augment, but look at that dubious challenge.
We would be dubious as hell. Our deck would be entirely... This would define our deck very well.
Yep.
Incredibly dubious. But no, Ripley is incredibly powerful. She's either a 4-3 or a 2-1 with a team. And in our deck, we can... God, this is a deck that really wants, like, that Mythic Angel, you know, like...
Yes, oh god, yeah, I was just thinking about that. I was like, man, it'd be great to pick up that one up, but...
Mythic.
Man, that's not gonna happen at this point.
Yeah.
We got our Mythic.
We got our Mythic. We already...
It's paying for the draft, but,
We got our Mythic. It's just... It's sitting right here. This is sort of the reason I wanted to draft this at the shop, because I still need a couple Gear Hulks, so...
Like I said, I do have that Gear Hulk to provide to you if you want.
I'm aware.
Oh, that Bruiser is actually a pretty good guy.
Yeah, that versus Eddie Trailhawk.
Yeah, which is flying and would like can get to the skin a bit more. Then again, the Bruiser has Menace himself.
Right, pretty easy Menace with all the Fabricate we have hanging around.
Right, and the nice thing about Menace here in this set specifically is that it means that even though it is one toughness, it can't just get chomped by a Servo. Like it could get jumped by two servos, but that's still like a much better value proposition than just being like, okay, I got this guy for free, so take it, I guess.
You'll lose the President Ark. You will lose the game if you do that. Do not do that. The dubious challenge is a May. So that if you put Phage the Untouchable in the choice in the cards that you can use, we found our payoff card, by the way.
Yeah, hell yeah, we did. Holy shit.
One of the things I tend to bring up about drafting is that if you follow the currents of the draft, if you listen, if you put your ear to the floor and listen to what the draft tells you, we saw the black, we followed it. You get rewarded for your faith. This is our reward. This is the payoff.
Which, like, that's not great in every deck, but it's pretty great in our deck. Because we can just make so many if we get animation module going with that, if it just have our, like, okay.
I'll live fast. We can't use that energy, but I'll take the draw.
Mm-hmm.
I don't think we can use that energy at all.
The other option is Fortuitous Find.
Is that better than Live Fast?
We're not going to really have many artifacts in the art, actually. Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot.
Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot might not even be in the deck.
Yeah, so you're just going to get a spec of creature, so it's not great. Yeah, Live Fast is definitely a better choice here, then.
Malphus Squad. Hazardous Condition is a powerful card. I had a lot of...
Yeah. I like Hazardous Conditions because it really well defines, like green, white, black are kind of nebulous in this set because they are all very heavy on, like, fabricate stuff. So it's kind of hard to, like, see the difference between all of them, but I think that Hazardous Conditions really shows that, like, green, black really wants to, +1/+1 onto itself and not make the artifacts as much.
Mm-hmm. And, like, this card was so powerful in we're cutting the Gear Hulk.
Yeah.
It's been sitting here, it's been waiting, it's been having a fun time. I'm not taking
it. I'd rather Puzzle Nut. Not, we're not using playing either, so.
Cathartic Reunion's a lot more powerful in this set because of what I talked about, how, like, there's no, there's few mana sinks, so, like, it turns your late game into, like, I discard three lands, and, two lands.
All right, I need to step away for a moment, so I'm going to let you handle deck building, but I'll be back, hopefully, by the time game one starts.
Sounds good. Looks like we don't have that many cuts to make, and there's some that I think look pretty simple. Metal Spinner's Puzzle Knot doesn't really have a place in the deck. Especially if we have Live Fast. We don't have a lot of, like, we need an artifact on for this to function. I also don't think I want Accomplished Automaton in the deck. That's a little too hefty for my liking. The Tutor is, not really that great. The Procta Club Security is probably getting cut. That's, like, four already. I'm not making any moves yet because I'm looking at... Just looking at card. I'm looking at what Wispweaver Angel does in the deck, and I like it. Acrobatic Maneuver might get cut because of the Wispweaver Angels. Alright, let's do that. So that. Ambitious Aetherborn. Metal Knot. Pillar Bug's not that great. DC Sports, I have no idea what you're talking about. I'm going to put every card that has Fabricate in a pile, and then you can go ahead and tell me that the Skiff isn't good in our deck, alright? Like, are you... Like, I seriously don't know what the hell you're talking about. what else do we want to cut? I think Acrobatic Maneuver would be a fine cut. And then, like, maybe Live Fast? Live Fast is just a 3-mana... Like, it is still, it's draw 2, lose 2 for 3. What's a bigger flyer than Wispweaver Angel? basically like some rares. I'm gonna go with Acrobatic Maneuver out, and I think it actually is gonna be Live Fast. Fretwork Colony's fine. Yeah, I think it's gotta be Live Fast. Yeah, pff, compare this to the copter. Wow, this card's a piece of shit. Like, all right. Looking like white gets the nod. Am I looking at that right? Yeah, white gets the nod. Looks like you might get a 10-7 nod, actually, on the double whites. We spent the first couple picks, like, kind of following what we thought colors might be open. There was a point where I picked a Thriving Rhino. I picked a Thriving Grubs because red was open. And then we picked up a... I think we picked up Weaponcraft Enthusiast. And then we saw black was quite open, and that's where we are now. We'll go ahead and add basics. Yep, 10-7. And this was our rare in pack two. At that point, we had Thriving Rhino and Gear Hulk as our only two green cards, and it's like, well, maybe we can still play it, because our black was only three or four cards deep, but green, again, was just gone, so we didn't fight over that. We just went ahead and accepted that I picked a Gear Hulk. Yeah, we picked up three arrests and five cards in our first picks. Like, it was, I think our first picks were something like this. And then a Propeller Pioneer, I think, was number four, followed by another Revoke or something like that. It was pretty close. Let me get the Rhino out of the deck.
All right, I am back.
Hello.
So, see, we cut...
Let me get my CMC, yep. So that's...
So, Live Fast out, Maneuver out, Club Security out, makes sense. Puzzle all out. It makes sense.
Yep, so yeah, this is the deck.
And then I think if we need to just have like a little bit more, and then we can always bring in like Live Fast if we need a bit more card draw or the or Puzzle Knot.
Yeah, we have those options. Yep.
Yeah.
All right. Sweet. Feeling good. Mm-hmm. We have good removal.
Yes. Oh yeah.
Gear Hulk in, add 4/4, and we're good. I wish we could support the Gear Hulk. My sealed I played on Saturday last weekend at the PPTQ was green, white, black.
Yeah. They put instructions on the bottom now. You can click a little arrow on the right to get rid of it.
Okay. So I'd like to play first.
Looking like a bit of a mole to me.
Yeah, the hotkey I always end up using is F6ing a turn.
I don't know. I mean, this hand doesn't do anything to revoke privileges, and that's the only thing it does.
Yeah, that's the biggest problem here. Is like it needs like a fabricator for this hand to function. I'm gonna mulligan it.
Yeah. This looks...
Worse.
Better. Worse? I mean...
This looks like the same hand, but with less things to do and no flyer.
You can play a blocker here.
Right.
You have a creature to play. It can't attack, but, like, you can play it. Yeah. We have a consulate.
Yeah. It was a swamp away from being a good hand, which means it's a bad hand.
Yeah. Yeah, like how many swamps were we playing?
There's seven.
Like seven that. Swamps in the deck, huh?
Yeah.
So we had a, you know, less than a quarter chance. So by the time we needed a swamp, you probably
oh my god.
One.
Well.
We found them. Great.
All right.
They're playing their buzzing lot, sure.
Yep. Well, we found the competition. Now we just need to eliminate them.
Yep. Well.
Goodbye, everybody.
Looks like that's not happening this game. At least now if we... Yeah, let's try it. Come on, you can do it, buddy. Okay, legal attack. Dang. Attack. Dang.
Right. I just see.
Bubble Mott is 2 to sack, right?
3 to sack.
3 to sack, okay.
That's why I'm not playing just, it.
Yeah. I'm hoping here that they're just gonna sack that. No, they're okay.
Okay.
Like, honestly, them doing stuff like setup stuff like this is... There it is, okay.
Okay, and I'm gonna make it wide.
Yep, because we want to be able to use that competition. And then we can also build to last the token.
Servo.
Crow.
Cambot. Alright.
Now, next turn, we can attack. Alright, what do they got for us in turn 4?
I would say, hopefully, something I can capture by the consulate, but.
Or maybe just nothing and we can Malphis squad.
Alright, let's bring it in.
Wait. Could they have the Wrath? Do you respect that enough?
In limited?
Yeah, fair enough. I mean, mostly because they passed on 4.
If they're playing a removal
okay,
here spell.
Alright, yeah. Then,
no,
yeah,
no,
then I don't. Yep, cool. Alright, sweet. That makes it way easier for us. Thank you.
Yeah.
I could have built to last that to save it, but I don't think that's really worth it.
I want to use that as a trick in combat more than that.
Yep. Like, and go wide again.
Yeah, we'll use
I mean, the thing is, that's probably going to be unblockable next turn anyway, unless they just slam down two creatures right now.
The big reason I didn't build to last there was because I wanted to continue building my board rather than... Okay.
That's what I was worried about. Well... Oh, please. Please, plus one counters.
Yeah, I was gonna say, just... am I gonna have to eliminate the competition? Is that how this is gonna have to go?
You might. That's why I'm hoping that they, you know, just put the plus one counters on it.
Then I would just, like, eliminate the competition as a 5-mana... Kill,
yeah.
Destroy target.
I mean, sometimes, okay, they decided not to do that. You still may need to do that.
If I draw a land.
Like,
if I draw a land.
Yeah, right.
Nope. Like, bruiser pass?
Yeah, basically. Yeesh. Because like, you don't really want to capture the angel.
No, that doesn't,
like,
that doesn't do anything.
Turns out bad. Yeah, I guess the bruiser. Like, it's another menace creature.
Yeah.
Like, honestly, we need. Like, if we play that, then we get another land. You know, we can, like, eliminate. You know, like, we're still at 20. Like, I honestly don't think we're in that bad a position here.
Well, we're on a 5-turn clock.
Yes. but we cannot, but we need a land, right?
Yeah.
Like, and if we can eliminate the competition sacking our servos, well, I guess we can't sack both our servos, otherwise our guy loses menace, but hopefully they also play another, like, high-value target here. What if they also got an angel of flicker?
I think at that point we just lose to that line. Because they'll have like 4 servos still in play after we sack our board to kill off their...
Yeah. Yep.
Do we attack with a 3-1? No.
No.
this is never blocking it, like, and I don't want to sack one servo. But, like, basically, I would have to burn my built to last to kill two servos, and I would two for one myself.
Still lose that. Yeah. And then they would still have that guy left. It's, like, it's just not worth it.
Yeah. That's literally two for zeroing myself, so...
All right. They don't need to do anything else. They're not going to. Well,
Maybe attack with both of my menacers?
I think so.
That's so bad.
It is, but, like, honestly, how does attack with everything look? Like, how does attack with the Glintsleeve Artisan and your other two dudes look?
Like, not the servos?
Yeah, just leave the servos back as, like, emergency blockers.
Would I want to capture it by the consulate on that angel?
I think you might want to wait one more turn on that. You can't kill it next turn.
It turns off any of our opponent's combat tricks.
That's true.
Was the thought, but also it means that
it means that their anthem sticks around.
Right.
Until they decide to, you know, they need to just spend a kill spell to get rid of it. Like, get rid of the console things, so they can deal with our stuff.
Right. But if they have an anthem, they won't need to.
Right.
Yeah, that's why I'm thinking about the capture by the consulate, is because it prevents their combat tricks, and they left four mana up.
Yeah.
Not having the fifth land, it sucks so hard here.
Yeah, well, I think maybe you just do that so you can attack in, because then, like, any single target removal spell they're going to cast this turn, they just can't use. Or they have to use before combat.
Well, actually, they can still impeccable timing. It doesn't actually prevent that. Like, it's an if-able, they just do it.
Right, and they can't redirect, so that wouldn't do it. So, yeah, I guess that, like, do you just pass? Or do you, like, attack with the Emperor Bruiser by itself? Okay. I like getting in for damage, as long as those things aren't blocking.
Burnhead, there are 19 minutes on the clock.
Yeah.
Come on, friend.
Okay.
Like, seriously? And again, I don't want to burn built to last.
Yeah, here you just let this happen.
On, like, literal nothing. Because again, it doesn't save my creature from dying.
Right.
God, I really wish I could kill that angel.
Just a land away. Probably just gonna be land away the rest of the game, but we're just a land away.
They didn't pop their puzzle nut.
They didn't. They didn't do anything. So, point for us, I guess.
Yeah.
All right. What big thing do you got?
Okay. A 4/3 Death Toucher.
That's a second target.
Yeah. So, yep. Lifelink back up. That's quite literally the last of the cards we couldn't cast, too. So
then, how do you feel about Cash for the Consulate and Undoomed Operative?
I think I'm attacking with Malphus Squad.
Yeah,
and that'll kill Doomed Operative.
Okay, that's worth going. That's worth doing.
Okay.
Yeah, or they just take three because, you know, they have a 4 power lifelinker in the air. This will turn off any of their single target removal, you know, with exceptions, but...
I mean, they respond with it.
Right, yeah.
Oh, okay, yeah. Metal Spoon.
Oh, sure. Okay.
The thing I thought you were going to do last turn.
Definitely lost games forgetting that I should sack a puzzle lot before the end of the turn.
Mm-hmm.
and just passing turn with the mana up and then just sitting there very sad. All right, one land. It's all we need.
We can eliminate all the competition.
We can. Like, there's that one dude that can't attack. And maybe, like, yeah, okay.
Okay.
Yep, that has two targets. Another reason my spell strength is quite good. Fortunately, that does not increase their clock. It's still a, still a three-turn clock.
Mm-hmm. And now because they subtle struck, I can't subtle strike to kill their angel.
Great. Fantastic.
I just have to pass, right? I have nothing.
Yeah, you just have to pass.
And this has been the game of being a just like being one off, being a turn behind, being our opponent doesn't have
every land.
Yeah, I was gonna say they haven't missed a land drop yet, so
It's turn 9 and they played 8.
Oh, did
they missed a land drop.
Okay. Oh, paying a train.
Okay, sure. It's a good card. They can use their operative to crew it, but
so yep.
All right, stay attacking the air. Yep, makes sense. All right, last chance. Oh, unless they just have a combat trick here, huh?
Oh, your team.
Oh, yes. Oh, he's going to live. I probably want to put on our artisan.
Yeah.
Because that's just bigger. It makes it so they can block a servo, no problem.
I'll check it out. We're gonna lose to the Renegade Freighter.
Live. Well, they can't attack with it if they if we kill the operative with the because that's crew 2 or crew 3 on it, right?
It's crew 2.
Yeah. So if we can get rid of the if we eliminate those two, then they won't have power enough. Well, I guess they could play power enough, but do we want to even show it at this point then?
Right. Like,
do we think we're winning the game? As it doesn't seem like we're winning the game at this point.
They would have to have literal two blanks in their hand.
It gains trample, right? So we could, like, no, we don't have any mana. They'd have to have blanks. They'll have to have anything that has a power. So I would say we just kind of lose here.
Let's move on.
Yeah.
All right. Anything?
Anything that would be good against our opponent?
Yeah, like I'm looking around. Here. We don't have like a -1/-1 their team or anything like that hanging out.
How does mind rot seem?
What's worse than that in our main?
Nothing really.
Yeah, that's the...
Like, maybe Malphus Squad or the, because it can just kind of get got. Well, then again, we can just make it so it doesn't get got by fabricating onto itself.
Right.
So. Yeah, I mean, I think that this is looks fine. Maybe we see some other stuff we need to do.
I'm going to try drawing a curve rather than drawing our 5 and our 2 sixes in a hand with 4 lands. So
that'd be cool.
Like, play first, yes. Like, to mulligan, yes.
Jeez. Well, we have great threes. We have a scry.
Okay.
Top that. Top that land. Okay.
Okay, that's good.
Now we are, it's a non-creature spell too, which means they can get it down before they start casting, like, all their equipment and stuff. Their trucks.
The 42 card deck.
Interesting. Wowzers, they're playing a lot of equipment.
Yep. Well, this card's quite good. A lot more cards than you'd expect are artificers in this set. More cards.
Oh, yeah. Okay, no white yet, so this is probably going to be like Puzzle Knot or nothing.
Okay.
Interesting.
let's go ahead and get Comble down.
Let's get that guy down. He is a magnet for removal, but it makes them drain for that removal spell, so.
Yeah. Like, if they have the black one, like, 3 damage thing. Mm-hmm. Oh, or...
Oh, okay, then. Or they're stuck on 2.
Glint Sleeve, I think, is the play here after attacking. We're gonna go wide.
And, like, it does mean if they draw, like, a Puzzle Knot or something to try to get out of it, they take 3 for that.
Yep. Yeah, Puzzle Knot's real bad. Heck, even if they have the drain for 3, the 3 mana Black Helix, like, they still take, they only gain 1 off
yeah.
it.
Yeah. We gain 2, and yeah, they gain 1.
Okay, fine. Okay.
So that means we no longer attack with our 2-3, but that's fine. Ooh, Sky Skiff.
I could just revoke it.
That seems fine, honestly, because that seems like a pretty good crew thing, and I mean, it's a 3-1 flyer, like...
Yeah,
and like this means we get to get in for 5?
Yeah.
And they still can't cast removal spells or anything that's not a creature, so... Without taking more damage.
Yes. I'll be happy to do, like... Okay, they're still off white.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Sure.
Security's here.
Yep.
I think I want to get the Sky Skiff down.
Yeah. Because the skiff means we can start attacking in the air with for 2 a turn.
Yeah.
That means we can, like, if we need to, we can activate the skiff, double block the artisan in the skiff. If they decide they want to attack with their security.
I will just take, or we just take 3. Yeah.
Or just take 3, yeah.
Want to get some of the menace down here, too. It seems quite good to have. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay.
Is Malphus Squad just going to be, is that going to be wide, or is that going to be on top? Because if he goes on top, then it can take out the security.
So let's go...
Mm-hmm.
Crew. Attack for 2. Let's see what they have. I assume they have a trick here.
I would guess.
I assume it's a 3 damage.
Mm-hmm.
But
please be on the skiff. It's on the skiff.
Okay.
So they gain 1 life, we gain 2 life, and we lose a skiff. So yeah, I think that then we want to put this squad on, we want to up its own power.
Yeah.
Because, like, it means that they have to then block it. It means they can't, you know, then, you know, -1/-1 it to get rid of it.
And +1/+1 counter. There's their white.
Okay.
No angel, though. That's double.
Yeah, that's double. Mm-hmm. We're 2 lands away from our Wistweaver angel doing anything.
Okay, I'm assuming that's making a 1/1.
Yeah, I would guess.
Because it's also a artificer, so that's a 5/5.
Mm-hmm. Which means... Yeah, so we can't really... Well, we can... Yeah, we can't really attack anymore.
Yeah. That's fine.
Mm-hmm. Now, capture by the console this year would be fantastic.
I kind of want to get Fretwork down.
Yeah, I think that's how we're going to get through finally. So, Fretwork and the Bruiser.
And no real attacks.
Yeah. I mean, we got some stuff down early, but then, like...
Yeah, I was going to say, basically, we
just got the biggest board, like, immediately.
Well, basically, we couldn't pressure him quickly enough.
Mm-hmm. All right, is this going to be, like... Oh, okay.
Okay, that's powerful.
I think I'm kind of big. I would like to, before they can get, like, sack anything or get rid of anything, I would love to see, Okay.
All right.
Sure. That is... Life to feed our colony with, so thank you.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd say you don't have any good attacks.
Okay. That gets us closer to the angel.
What do I want to do with the Malphist? Do I want another servant here?
You're not getting through it. It's a 4-power creature, so I think so.
Like, I kind of want to have some more servos hanging out so that I have more things to sack.
Yeah, to sacrifice. Yeah, I would agree with that. Plus, then it gives you another, like, you know, if something happens to, like, the Glintseeve artist, then you could also refresh this guy with the angel to get another one.
Yeah. So.
Make sure that we have a larger board than our opponent does at all times.
Basically.
Get that, you know, second planes and get in play their angel.
Yep. That's going to be a big problem the turn they play that second planes and play that angel. However, our angel is going to be really nice when it comes down. Okay. 3-2 Death Toucher.
That's not that's too powerful, scary here.
Powerful card, though.
It is.
Yep, still no attacks.
Then, yeah, then they can spend mana to make another servo at the end of their turn.
Yep.
Keep getting bigger. Ooh.
Okay.
A bad little guy.
Hey, Pillar Bug. How big do we want that Fretwork Colony before I start getting in with it? I mean, Dunned Operative answers it immediately, but, like...
Right. I would probably say, like, I mean, honestly, I think we'd want to just hold on to it until, like, we can break their board somehow.
What is that? What, I guess our Embrace is, or our Eliminate is our board breaker?
Yeah. Right.
Yeah.
That's what my thought was, because we could, you know, sacrifice our two servos, like, let's see if Artisan kill, like, you know, their two big, like, their three black creatures, and then they'd be stuck with, like, well, and then probably also the, okay.
Alright. Let's get the lanes down. Okay.
Hmm? Yep. Alright. What am I getting with it this turn?
That doesn't sound bad at all.
Yeah.
That probably just eats Doomed Operative. But I think that's okay.
Yeah, that seems fine to me.
Okay.
Like, and it gains us 5.
Yeah. Basically, if I can kill Ambitious Aetherborn, I'll feel good too. But...
Yeah. Or maybe they're just going to, like, put the Aetherborn. Okay. Then, yeah. They're going to make sure that, like, there's. That, like, reduces the number of tricks that just gets them, but we have the trick that, you know, just gets them.
So, Ninth Bridge Patrol.
Yep, that guy gets a little bit bigger. And, okay.
Also, now we have a bunch of life to pay for our...
Right, so that guy can keep getting bigger. And now the fact that, like, they don't have a,
Yep.
There it is. Double so this probably means that their whole team is going to get huge, and they're going to have, like, a 4-3 flyer.
Yeah, very likely. I just assume that card is in our opponent's hand.
Oh, absolutely. Like, why else would you keep a hand with no white in it?
Oh, Gearsmith. Oh. Okay.
Okay. Picking sure. up Getting the, back.
Dunned Operative, I'd bet.
Yeah. Because, like, their Cogwar puzzle, like, gets some more creatures, but also...
Pays
Yeah. Like...
Well, Doomed Operative answers our, again, our Fretwork
yes,
Colony.
Yes, exactly. Which is why we just hope that we can, like, get our Eliminate the Competition and, you know, get rid of basically anything that they have that's threatening.
Yeah, that's definitely what I'm looking
Doomed
for.
Operative back down. Okay. Well, that means that they don't actually have the Angel in hand.
Yeah.
So if they did, they absolutely would have played it there, because that's, like, a... That's time to play it. Okay, what do we flicker?
Probably Malphus Squad, this one.
Yeah.
And...
That gives us another servo to sack. And then, like, they probably move their Inventor's Goggles onto their Skywheel Swirl Harrier.
Yep.
So we can't actually attack. But, you know...
More servos.
Yep.
And look at this board.
This board is extremely wide. Of course, he went up against the mirror round one.
Yep. So this has been my finding with the format, is that you just end up in these ridiculous, he top decked it. Okay.
Yep, there it is.
So you end up in these ridiculous board stalls where nobody, like, everybody just sits around and nothing happens.
Yeah.
This is like, I've seen this happen in a lot, in Big Flyer, of course, too. Goggles over to it means it doesn't die in combat to Wisp Weaver.
Yep. Oh boy, this means they're probably getting in with everything this turn now, right?
They don't lifelink. If they get in with everything, I'll kill them back.
Oh, fair enough.
Like,
I mean, they're probably going to try to get them some stuff, though, right?
Probably.
Like, or nothing. Okay, competition. Let's eliminate it.
God, I wish. I want it.
Land.
Yeah.
Okay.
How many actual kill spells do we have for that angel? Is it just eliminate the competition?
I think it's the only actual kill spell, yeah.
Okay.
Well, let's fight it. You thinking about attacks here, or are you just thinking about what to do next?
I'm thinking about attacking with the fire, with the fretwork colony.
It just trades at the, with their 6/6.
I know.
Like, I don't think we have any good attacks here. Which sucks, but, like, I think the fretwork colony is, like, most likely the way that we eventually win this game is it just being ridiculously big and then not being able to answer it.
Problem is we don't have any way to force it through.
Right. Like, basically, like, at this point in the game, we just hope that we get eliminate the competition in the next 2 or 3 turns.
Yeah.
And if we don't, then we just kind of lose.
Okay, yep, that's what I thought. Moving makes the goggles makes a lot of sense with the Wisp Weaver. They get to attack for 5 lifelink. That's probably what they just do for a couple turns, is 5 lifelink attack.
Right. Oh, they got other stuff.
Oh, hey!
Jesus, they attack for way more lifelink in the air. Oh my god. Well, they can't really attack with that one at this point.
Yeah.
Like, I could also attack with that, or they just don't.
Because I held a card up.
Yeah, we have no more use for that land, so no use for that land either. So that's cool.
And we have no way to even turn those lands into anything else. Nope. Because I showed the subtlety that earlier, in one of our matches, he's respecting it. So.
Mm-hmm. And that's just, keep pretending we have it.
Is his wincon wait till fretwork colony kills us?
Yeah, sure.
That works too.
Cool.
I wish we had that ninth bridge so that I could infinite Wisp Weave. Alright, fretwork colony doing its thing. Play one of those to make it look like, you know.
Yeah, make it look like that was like the land that we just drew.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so that's our 9th land out of the deck, so we have 8 more left, so it's a 40% chance on a land next turn, which means we're getting a land next turn.
To be quite honest, this is a 1 in 20.
Yeah. I mean, yeah. Anything would be nice, but like,
we only have 1 real out.
Right.
Oh, rip in peace our flyer. Okay.
Okay, or not.
Then they gain 1, 2, 3, 4
a lot.
4 off of that. So, yep. And now I don't have flying blockers, which means I'm going to be taking.
They get in. Yep, they get in with a bunch. So yeah, eliminate the competition or bust. And even that doesn't really get us out that easily anymore, because we basically have to sack like a bunch of our other stuff.
Yep, okay, so we take 8 in the air, lifelink for 8.
Oh, I'll probably attack this guy Swirlhawk there as well, but. Because that would have had us, like, dead next turn? Oh my god. Alright. And just, yeah, put the Doom Daughter operative in front of it.
That's fine. I have to make it look like something here, though.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I don't think it's removal as much as breakers. Mm-hmm. Like, we had the board, like, in a even position for way too long. I actually, so the real reason I threw that away is, okay, yeah, like, we're dead in two to the air, right? Yeah, we're dead in two to the air. The fact that it's lands running doesn't matter because we're only on a one out because of how our deck functions right now. That certainly isn't it.
Yeah. Well, that's the game then.
Yeah.
I mean, four lands running certainly did not help.
No, it didn't assist us. I'm going to attack with a bug.
Like at least, you know, getting some more stuff on the ground may have, like, helped out. But...
He didn't even block that.
Yeah, I mean, what's the point? He's at 28.
Do, 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 do. Okay,
thank you.
I figured
like,
it
why
out.
Why are we not attacking with that entire time? Like, what were we going to do?
Because it doesn't have vigilance.
So, who cares? So
it doesn't have vigilance.
Like, you have all this stuff on the ground to block. You're at an enormous life total. Like, okay. Aside from our opponents having some pretty good cards, I think we kind of lost that one to two shitty hands.
I feel like I'm laughing at the point that we played against the person that we knew. Like, we knew this person existed.
Right. And, or that, like, if they weren't, maybe if somebody's flashing it, but, like, chances are somebody was just taking that because it's a good card. Right. Yeah.
And this is basically what the plan was that you go ahead and you use these, you make servos, you make a team, and...
And you make a use of them somehow.
I think what this, again, what this tells me is, again, kind of stressing what I already know about the format, which is that, like, stall breakers and evasive creatures are so, like, again, flying. Flying is super key. So that's that's definitely... Oh, let's do this. Draw a card. Okay.
Ooh, that would have done something. Like, almost, actually.
It would have been like...
You could make our Menace guy bigger, and then we would have gotten another servo from that.
I'm just sad I didn't get to play with animation module. I like
It's too bad, because that, like, that would have been... Like, man, imagine that hand if we had that turn one.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, then we could all of a sudden, like, for one extra mana, we could both, we could choose both modes of Fabricate.
Basically. Alright, anyway, let me, I'm like...
Return to data.
Fuck, it's one of these buttons, right? I think I've got play points hanging around for another one. Are you up for another?
Yeah, definitely.
That one went quicker than I expected, so I...
Just to clarify, this is a run back and not a salty run back, right?
See, here's the thing. So... I don't... I'm trying to think how many times I've gotten, like, actually angry about a game of Magic, and I think I can count it on, like, a single hand.
Mm-hmm. See, like...
I love losing to things like that because it, like that. See, that was something we talked about in the middle of the draft. We talked about, oh, what if we have the Mythic Angel? You know,
right.
And our opponent had it.
I would be too if the game were closer. You know, like if we actually had something to respond to that. Like, and also, like one of the reasons why I love the word salty so much is because I don't feel like I get angry so much after games like that. Like, I don't know but, like, I feel like salty really well describes the emotion I feel at the end of that. Because it's not sad, it's not angry, it's just kind of, like, a little bit resentful. And, like really wishing that things just didn't happen that way. But, anyway.
I get like that if I'm the one who made the mistake to lose the game. Like, there was a really good example of that in the Sorin days. There was a game that I lost to my own misstep, and like that, you know, I got quite irate at myself over it.
Yeah.
Anyway, let's I'm gonna go ahead and clip the stream. So it's just going to be a different I'm just gonna change the stream title and flicker the recording. I'm not actually gonna drop the stream though. So this will just be a moment. I'm gonna put up the little intermission screen that I have. So be back in a little bit.